Today's topic is correlation receiver. Correlation receivers are nothing but what is it actually? So, a correlator comprises of a multiplier. It is going to have your received signal x of t multiplied with the replica of the input signal. So, the input signal here it is taken as ck of t. It is a replica of the input signal. You are going to just multiply these two signals, and the product of this is integrated over a time period of 0 to t. That is, it is sampled. Okay, the output is sampled and it is fed to a decision making device where the decision is going to have a threshold. Based upon the threshold, whether the signal is above the threshold or below the threshold, the bit is considered as either 1 or 0. So, this is the basic principle of a correlator receiver. Correlation is nothing but it correlates the received signal R of t with the stored replica of your known signal Ck of t. So, this is the block diagram. And the product is integrated over one simple period, that is t. And this comprises of two subsystems. One is t modulator or detector, another one is vector receiver. So, first part or the first subsystem of this correlation receiver is nothing but detector. So, what this detector comprises of is array of such correlators. So, you can see that the received signal is going to be multiplied with each and every corresponding coherent reference signals. So, f1 of t, f2 of t, fn of t, or these are the reference signals. You are going to multiply that with the received signal, and this product is integrated over a time period of 0 to t. And these signals are going to be said to be orthonormal basis functions. Okay, and it is sampled at regular intervals of time at t is equal to capital T, which is the symbol period, and the output is going to be fed to the detector. So, the output is going to be a vector quantity is going to be fed to the detector. So, before that, seeing the detector part of it, we will see what is this received signal actually is. So, your received signal is Rk, which is nothing but integrated over 0 to t with the received signal Rt into this reference signal. See, the reference signal is Fk of t. Fk ranges from 1 to n. And this is going to be your Sm of t, the reference signal along with your noise, the original signal along with the noise. So, this Rk is represented by Smk plus Nk. And this is received signal with whose vector quantity is going to be fed to the second subsystem, that is going to be the vector receiver. So, what is this vector receiver comprises of is, going to be having n elements of x, and it is first multiplied with the corresponding n elements of the each m symbols of the vectors. So, here m signal vectors available are s1, s2 up to sm, and you are going to multiply this with the received signal, and it is summed up, which is going to be said to be an array of accumulators which forms a set of inner products. So, the product is received signal, the vector quantity x value into s1 of t, x value into s2 of t. So, each and every product is going to be integrated over or summed up, or all these are called as set of accumulators. And then the products are corrected for the fact that the transmitted signal energies may be unequal. And this is going to be your summation accumulator part, and it is fed to the select a largest of it. So, finally, the largest in the resulting set you are going to have set of received signal. You are going to have a decision making over here. You are going to check whether it is the largest in the resulting set of the number is selected and the corresponding decision on the transmitted message is made. So this is going to be your optimum receiver or correlation receiver.